The project to build sports facility is one of the largest project, and it will certainly have an impact on the environment close to it. So for this situation, the project will be implement near residential housing. Therefore, this issue must be taken seriously and not overlooked in order for the project to be carried out in a safe and secure environment. A new guidance and standard practice need to focus on the concept of sustainable development planning system by restructure the main purpose of building the sport arenas. There are three concepts that involve in sustainable construction. There are environment, social well-being and economic prosperity. For environment, the potential impact of this sport arena project is that people living around this sport arena will not have any environmental problems. This is because this sport arena project will comply with the Green Building Index, that is GBI requirement. By complying this requirement for this project, the community around this sport arena will not have any environmental problems. Next, for economy, the potential implication for this concept is that it can improve the economy of society in the sport arena. This is because usually people will have to pay the rent. Apart from that, this sport arena also can help the food store around it. As the result, this arena project can have a good impact on economic concept and maintain economic sustainable for future generation. The last one is social. For the potential of this impact is that it can help the community and support society such as university students and people living around the sport arena to unite and maintain a healthy lifestyle. This is because by exercising, we can maintain our health and avoid any illness such as obesity. By doing our sport arena, we can help the community and society to maintain their health and bring society together, because there are usually a lot of people in this sport arena.
Principle of sustainable construction. First principle we got is procurement, which is specific procurement strategies is to ensure sustainable construction requirements are addressed. For second principle is site and environment. Methods or to reduce environment impact of construction of the project site and surrounding environment are identified. For third is a material selection, which is identify environmentally friendly building materials as well as harmful toxic materials and should be avoided. For waste and prevention, methods to reduce eliminate waste on the construction project identified. Last but not least is recycling, which is it easy to identify materials to recycle to each phase of construction, to methods to support on a site recycling effort. And my friend will continue to the rest of principle.
So we continue with the number 6, which is energy. So we have to ensure and improve the building's energy performance, reduce energy consumed during construction, and identify opportunities to use renewable energy source. Next is building and material reuse. So we have to identify reusable materials and method to facilitate the future reuse of facility, system, equipment, product and materials. Next is health and safety. Methods to improve the quality of life for construction workers are identified. And lastly is indoor environment quality. So we have to ensure indoor environment quality measure during the construction, managed and executed properly.
There are seven principles of the sustainable construction. The first one, reduce resource consumption, reuse resources, reuse recyclable resources, protect nature, eliminate toxic, apply life cycles, costing, and the last one is a focus on the quality. These principles of a sustainable construction is applied across the entire life cycle of a construction, from planning until to disconstruction. This principle also applies to resources needed to create and operate the built environment during its entire life cycles: land, material, water, energy, and ecosystem.
Is that challenge or barrier of sustainable construction? So sustainable construction has become more prevalent over the last decade. So I thought sustainable construction is increasing more common. There are still barriers to the successful completion of sustainable project. So the first one is the barrier is the financial disincentive. So for example, lack of life cycle cost analysis, receive higher first cost, and the last one is budget separation between capital and operating cost. So that's the problem of financial disincentive. Okay, for the second one is the lack of awareness. is because of prevalence of conventional funding and also evasion of perceived risk. Commonly, a challenge in construction project is the lack of effective communication among the various technical experts who tend to use their own tool and industry standard for making the decision and creating information.